Hi, I'm Tom Petersen with Intel. Welcome to Episode 4, Architecture All Access Season 3. In Season 2, Episode 1, we explained AI fundamentals, discussing how neural networks deliver amazing experiences and how they translate into billions of computations on our hardware. If you missed it, a link to that episode is listed below. This season, in Episode 1, Tim highlighted our new CPU, Meteor Lake, and how that device will pave the way for the AI PC era. By 2025, we expect to ship over 100 million AI-accelerated devices. So today, let's dig deeper into that tech and see what powers it. AI is everywhere today, with new applications emerging in every industry. Sometimes, without even knowing, we use AI on a day-to-day basis, and that's only going to continue. For example, today AI is
enhancing audio, blurring video backgrounds, and removing objects and media, and more.
Soon, we'll see AI personal assistants that will organize your day based on private personal goals that you've set. Imagine an email assistant that makes sense of your inbox, turning random noise into a concise work list. And what if we can make these experiences even better, snappier, and more private? The way AI generally works on client PC today is data is sent up to the cloud, processed there, and then the result is sent back down to your PC. All this back and forth adds latency, lowering responsiveness, and exposes your private data to the public internet. For example, you may want to use AI for all your personal finances, but many of us don't want that data exposed in the cloud. Or often you may want to enhance photos with AI, but you don't want that data to be used publicly as input to another AI model. And for developers, on-device AI means quicker innovation without cloud costs or constraints. For client devices, AI generally refers to inferencing, like recognizing handwritten digits. In this example, let's look at a network that has been trained using the MNIST dataset, which contains millions of handwritten digits from 0 to 9. During inference, a new image is presented to this pre-trained network, and a prediction is made about the digit the input image most likely represents. The network makes this magic happen in layers. The initial layers are easiest to understand as they identify lines and curves in the new image. But later layers start to understand more semantic ideas like, hey, this image seems to be either a 3 or an 8. Each of these layers does a different mathematical function based on the network's design, using weights that were calculated during the initial training. In Meteor Lake, we integrated AI in three key areas of the architecture: CPU for quick, lightweight AI tasks, GPU, great for AI-infused media in 3D, and the NPU, our dedicated neural processing unit. Let's delve into the GPU. In the last episode, we discussed Meteor Lake's new Xe cores and vector engines. The vector engines support all major data types used for rendering, like FP32 and FP16, but also INT8, which is widely used for AI inference. Traditional 32-bit operations would leave a lot of performance on the table when executing operations that only require 8-bit. This is why we've added an instruction optimized for AI acceleration called DP4A. DP4A packs our traditional vector operations with INT8 values. It allows for 4x the throughput for most common operations used during inferencing. For example, DP4A lies at the foundation of our XeSS technology, a neural network-based upscaler, so you can get smoother gameplay at higher resolution. Now let's talk about the NPU, our dedicated neural processing unit. Central to it are the neural compute engines. We've embedded two, each boasting two programmable shave DSPs and a single inference pipeline optimized for matrix operations and supporting varied data types. The inference pipeline is used to run efficient and flexible matrix multiplication and convolution with support for activation functions and data conversions. The multiply accumulate, or MAC array, that sits inside the inference pipeline calculates up to 2048 MAC operations per cycle at very low power. It supports full matrix multiply and convolution and common inferencing data types such as INT8 and FP16. Each inference pipeline is supported by two DSPs that we call SHAVE, or Streaming Hybrid Architecture Vector Engines. The DSPs support a larger instruction set than the inference pipeline and execute less common, less dense scalar or vector operations with data types up to FP32. The dual neural compute engines are supported by 4 MB scratchpad RAM and come with dedicated DMA and MMU blocks to interface with the system memory. The combination of inference pipelines, DSPs, and purpose-built memory architecture give the NPU in Meteor Lake a great mix of programmability, performance, and efficiency. With all three resources, the NPU is able to execute a neural network independently with high efficiency. Let's return to my earlier example. Our inference pipelines are designed to run the most common algorithms directly in hardware, which minimizes latency and power. In this case, the convolution, pooling, and flattening layers are all supported. The last layer, softmax, runs on the shaved DSPs, which are designed to be flexible and implement any part of an algorithm that does not have native support in the inference pipeline. Of course, that was a very simple example, but it shows the basic operation you can expect in hardware to perform for AI. Modern neural network systems, however, have much more complex data sets and operate on much more complex networks. In the end, whether it's removing video backgrounds or generating images with AI, the fundamental technology is the same. Now, we all know that the hardware is just the beginning of the story. A complete software stack is required to deliver the promise of the technology. So we've developed a comprehensive AI software stack from drivers to libraries. Intel's strategy has always been about open ecosystems. And for the PC, there are multiple ways to implement AI inferencing, including our own OpenVINO framework, Onyx Runtime, WinML, and more. To build new AI experiences like generative fill in Adobe, AI recommendations in Avid, AI text editing in DaVinci Resolve, or video upscaling in Topaz, the software vendors use these APIs to leverage acceleration hardware. The software stack allows developers to target the CPU, the GPU, or the NPU, and deliver the best mix of performance and efficiency for the workloads they target. Or even use multiple accelerators at the same time for even more performance. The revolutionary experiences AI will bring to the PC will require a combination of CPU, GPU, and NPU working in tandem with a solid software stack and a broad software ecosystem. Meteor Lake will usher us into the AI PC era by bringing these capabilities to millions of systems. And to accelerate adoption of these new AI capabilities, we've recently launched the AI PC Acceleration Program, which provides developers with access to Intel's engineering talent for targeted software optimizations and tuning, software developer kits like OpenVINO, and go-to-market opportunities and more. For Meteor Lake, we're working with more than 100 developers on more than 300 AI-accelerated features. All of these AI innovations, combined with the rest of the revolutionary Meteor Lake technology, make this our largest client SoC shift in 40 years. Thank you for joining me today, and don't forget to catch episode 5 on packaging. Thanks for tuning in.